your experience of your life happens in the zone of chemicals and hormones, memories and emotions. Listen. Much of, I should say almost everything, you perceive, call, experience, understand, cognize as your life happens in the zone of hormones and chemicals, emotions and memories. Yaga is a single soul, most powerful catalyst agent to transform your Atma into Paramatma, soul into cosmic soul, Sava into Paramashiva, your individual existence to Paramashiva. Understand, Yaga brings focus, intense focus on your ultimate reality. I tell you, struggle is not wrong in your path to Kailasa, enlightenment, but losing focus is something seriously wrong. If you lost focus, you lost everything. Struggle is not something wrong. I tell you, too simple. You may be struggling with your Paramashiva space. Maybe only one problem you are focused, you are struggling, you are not able to complete. Maybe you are lust or the hunger pattern. But you are struggling with will persistence. I tell you, when you leave the body, these two patterns with which you are struggling, they become irrelevant and pure Paramashiva stands. And you just merge with him and become one with him. That is why I say struggling is not crime. But if you lost focus, if you come to the conclusion of, I'm not able to do anything, I struggled with this lust pattern and hunger pattern for 25 years, I can't do anything. So you lose focus or you consciously decide not to persist. Then, when you leave the body, this struggle will become irrelevant. The incompletion patterns will become irrelevant, I tell you. Your lust, your hunger, all the patterns related to your body, your hormones and chemicals are irrelevant when you leave the body. But the decisions you make are going to come with you. Because the deciding component of you, that will persistence, is going to assume the next body. Understand? This body is not going to come with you. So, the patterns related to the hormones and chemicals die with it and they become irrelevant. They actually become irrelevant. But, how you dealt, what kind of a reactions you gave, how you handled, cognized your hormones and chemicals and patterns related to that pattern, your will persistence pattern is going to come with you. Listen, understand that. So, if you don't give up, during your struggles, struggles will become irrelevant. When the struggles become irrelevant, you were already yearning so much to become one with Parameshwar, you will just merge into Him. I tell you, struggles are not wrong, but giving up or feeling it is not possible for you, sometimes the demon in you becomes so strong. You even feel it is not possible for anyone. So anyone who teaches the Shivanjana is cheat. Oh God, you go to that extent. Worst. Rakshasa. I tell you. Ravana. Maybe Asura, but never Rakshasa. Maybe he was struggling with his lust pattern. But he never felt the Paramashivanjana is not possible for him or it is not possible for the universe. I am not saying Ravana is right. All I am trying to tell is, before telling Ravana is wrong, you please become right and then tell Ravana is wrong. That's all. In every padigam, my Guru Mudalvar, Jnanasambandha Perumal, Guru Mudalvar means, all Adhyanams will have two histories. One, the history from Kailasa, that Tirukkailaya Parambarai Varalaru. The history from Kailasa, till one person who is known in the modern history, recent history. So the recent history, known reviver is considered as Guru Mudalvar for each Adhinam. So for Madhuri Adhinam, it is considered Jnanasambandhar is Guru Mudalvar. But when I see the actual history of Sthana Varalaru, Sthanigar Varalaru and all other mother documents, it goes much beyond. I think we have enough evidence. Meenakshi herself is a historical figure. She is not mythical figure. She is an historical figure who lived on planet Earth and revived the whole Shyamala Peeta, Sarvanya Peeta. Okay. That's a different subject. So, my Guru Mudalvar, every padigam, he sings about Ravana lifting the Kailasa. It means he was given so much of importance among the devotees. Even when he was struggling, he did not deny the possibility for himself or for world. But this Tripurasuras, the son of Tarakasura, sons of Tarakasura, Tarakasura, Kamala, this three, Vidyunmali, this three, because they were struggling, not only they denied the possibility for themselves, they started telling the whole world it's not possible for anyone. Rakshasas. Rakshasas. Not only they need to be destroyed, they should never be glorified. If you just remove Sita episode, Sita being kidnapped and that component, Ravana is absolute hero. Last day, before entering into the war, he goes with his Atmalinga. Means he does Shiva Puja, wears his Atmalinga back and goes to the war. That is why Vibhishana tells Rama, hey, don't send the arrow to his chest. Atmalinga is there, that will protect him. Cut his head. Which is wrong as per the rules of the war. You only have to open the chest and kill a brave hero who is standing in front of you. Anyhow, even when you are struggling, don't go to the low of Triparasuras, denying the possibility for yourself and for others. It's extreme, I tell you. Struggling is not at all wrong, but denying is seriously wrong. Shivanyana, Paramashivanyana is possible for you and for the whole universe. Guru is the statement from Paramashiva that Shivanyana is possible for individual and for the universe. That's first. Second, an incarnation makes it possible through powerful initiations, methods, creating an ambience. I tell you, every temple is the ambience, ecosystem.